In this video, we're talking about the nomenclature of ternary ionic compounds. So what does ternary mean? It just means that there's more than two elements in the compound. Remember, a binary ionic compound had only two elements. Ternary just means that there's more than two elements in there. Ionic still means that there's a cation and an anion. And as before, the cation is always written first in both the formula and the name, and the anion is always written last in both the formula and the name. So to name a ternary ionic compound, we name it the same way we do with a binary ionic compound. Just say the name of the cation, and then say the name of the anion. The difference between ternary ionic compounds and binary ionic compounds is that in a ternary ionic compound, there will always be at least one of what we call polyatomic ions. At least one polyatomic ion. All right, so what's a polyatomic ion? Fair question. Well, these are polyatomic ions. And polyatomic, poly means many, so two or more. Atomic means atoms. Ions means they have a charge. So these are different than the compounds we've been naming because these have charges and they're ions. Most of these you'll notice are anions. The only, in this table, there are only two cations, mercury one and ammonium. They're pretty uncommon. And so when there's, so the thing is, okay, first of all, memorize this table. Realistically, you're gonna put this on your card, but you should start memorizing it. Even though you will have your card and you'll be able to use it, you know, to see the names and formulas for these, it will be useful, and you'll see it'll be very useful for you to recognize a polyatomic ion when you see it without having to look it up in your on your card or in the table. And the important things to know are the formula, the charge, and the name. So for instance, sulfite is SO3, has a negative 2 charge, and it's called sulfite. Watch out for the letters. I mean, one little letter makes a difference. Sulfite as opposed to sulfate. Okay? These are two different polyatomic ions. And remember, a monatomic anion, sulfide, looks just like this except with a D instead of a T. So yeah, be real careful with those letters there. But you're gonna really wanna know, recognize these polyatomic ions. There are some more that I'm gonna ask you to memorize too. These eight others. Hypobromite, bromite, bromate, perbromate, hypoiodite, iodite, iodate, and periodate. There's a pattern here that hopefully will help you remember them. First of all, let's look at the bromates. These all have a bromine here, and it's just one. They all have oxygens. They all have a negative one charge. The only difference in the formula is how many oxygens there are, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And notice in the name, they all have brome in them. That's for the bromine. And if there's one oxygen, it's hypobromite. So it begins with hypo, ends in ite. Two oxygens, no prefix, ends in ite. Three oxygens, no prefix, six ends in ate. And four oxygens, the prefix is now per, and it ends in ate. And the same pattern is followed for iodine. Hypoiodite, iodite, iodate, periodate. All one oxygen, 1, 2, 3, or 4 oxygens, all negative one charges. The names still follow the same pattern. So memorize these guys too. So, naming ternary ionic compounds. So to name this compound right here, first thing we do is recognize that sodium is a metal. Carbon and oxygen are nonmetals, so it's going to be an ionic compound. There's more than two elements, so that means it's a ternary ionic compound. Once you realize it's a ternary ionic compound, you know there's going to be at least one polyatomic ion in there. Look for it. Find it. And so sodium is not a polyatomic ion. It's just sodium. The rest of it, CO3. Look on your table over here, and there it is, CO3. It's called carbonate. Has a negative 2 charge. So the name of the anion is carbonate. The name of the cation is sodium, no Roman numeral because it's not one of the metals that can have more than one charge state. So the name is just sodium carbonate. Easy as that. Here, this compound right here, zirconium, there's three of these, and a polyatomic ion, so it's a ternary ionic compound. So if we go down here, PO4 with a negative 3 charge is called phosphate. Now notice these parentheses here. Whenever you have multiple numbers of a polyatomic ion, you have to put that polyatomic ion in parentheses. In this case, what this means is that there are four PO4s, four phosphates, and this four applies to everything inside the parentheses. It's, if you think about the phosphate as one thing, you can see that there's four of those. So to name this, okay, there's a metal, zirconium, and because it was not on that chart, we have to use a Roman numeral to say its charge. So to figure out its charge, we're going to still use the rule that the total charge on the cations must equal the total charge on the anions. Well, there's four phosphates. Each has a negative 3 charge. So we have 12 negative charges here. We have to have 12 positive charges on the zirconium. They have to be split evenly over all three zirconiums. So if there's 12 negative charges split over three atoms, is going to be a positive 4 on each. So we'll call it zirconium 4 phosphate. Or if we use the little formula, there's 3 times the charge on zirconium plus 4 times the negative 3 on each one of the phosphates adds up to be 0. 3 times the charge on zirconium minus 12 equals 0. 3 times the charge on zirconium equals positive 12. Or the charge on zirconium is positive 4. Still giving us zirconium 4 phosphate. Now going from the name to the formula, say cobalt 3 acetate. Well, the cobalt 3 part's easy. Cobalt is just capital C, lowercase o. The 3 here, that tells us right there what the charge is. If there's no Roman numeral, then that means you'll know what the charge is from that table that I showed you in the last video. Acetate, again, this is where it comes in handy, recognizing the names and formulas of polyatomic ions. Acetate is the name of a polyatomic ion, and it's right here. Now, if we look over, we see that the formula for acetate is C2H3O2 with the negative 1. Well, balancing charges, we have 3 positive charges. We have to have 3 negative charges, which means we have to have 3 of these guys, 3 acetates. Well, to do that, we have to put parentheses around the acetate. I put a 3 outside. And there we have the formula for cobalt 3 acetate.